He's a far cry from the buff Ruff we saw as the Hulk. Mark Ruffalo's new role is taking a much darker turn. Now, inspired by an incredible true story, the shocking film Dark Waters sees Ruffalo risk everything, a tenacious attorney who uncovers a growing number of unexplained deaths linked to one of the world's largest corporations poisoning the water. Our London reporter Clint sat down with the Hollywood superstar.
Almost heaven, West Virginia.
Your grandma tells me her grandson's some fancy environment lawyer down in Cincinnati.
I am a corporate defense attorney.
So?
I defend chemical companies.
Well, now you can defend me.
Rob Bellott, Mark Ruffalo, thanks for your time.
Thanks,
and thank you for this film, Dark Waters. Well, thank you and not thank you. It's terrifying, but in a way that it has to be, I suppose.
Yeah.
For yourself, Rob, when someone tells you that, you know, an Academy Award nominee, slightly younger, guy that's known for playing the Hulk is going to play you in a film, what's your first thought that goes through your mind?
Wow. And it was really surreal to have Mark doing it, but really he did such a fantastic job, and he was really the perfect person. You know, he was so dedicated to the story and to bringing this whole issue out to a wider audience, and assembled such a great team to do it. It could not have asked for better people.
You need to tell me what in the hell's going on.
DuPont is knowingly poisoning 70,000 local residents for the last 40 years.
The story, did it get more personal when you met Rob?
Absolutely. And Rob brought us into that community, too. And, you know, I think the crystallizing moment is when you actually see Bucky Bailey in the movie. And you just see the manifestation, what this chemical actually does to human beings, the receptor, you know? And, you know, we all wanted to make sure that we were telling the story of this community and what these people had gone through and how real it was. Sometimes you forget when you're making a film that you're actually talking about real people, but they were there every day, so we were always aware of the importance of the story we were telling and the responsibility we had telling it.
They should see what they done.
You're right, they should. And it kills me that they won't. Earl, these companies, they have all the money, all the time, and they'll use it, trust me. I know, I was one of them.
It's a scary story. I mean, it's a story that fills you with rage and shock. But also, ideally, it's a story that sort of puts the questions of what to do next back in our hands. You know, it doesn't really end with a silver bullet. And I think that's true about the issues that we face as a culture, you know?
And how did it come to you? Did you read the New York Times piece, or was it Mark, or?
It was Mark. It was that first, I mean, it was very quickly after the appearance of the New York Times
piece. I heard that, so this is unusual, I guess.
It's very unusual. And it was Mark's urgency and passion, but it was also participant media, you know, the studio that produced the film, who are driven by social justice themed projects. They felt that this movie had tremendous relevance, as I think we all felt when we discovered the story, and wanted to get it out well before the election year.
You want to take everything that you know and turn it against an iconic American company like an informant. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? Isn't that right?
Yes.
Are you scared? I know there's the scene in the film which I'm told is real in the car park.
Yeah.
Are you scared of these big companies now that it's out?
No.
Oh, good.
Not really. I mean, you certainly can go down that road and you're alone and alienated, and sometimes the community turns on you because they have an allegiance to these companies because of their paychecks, and they do horrible things. Obviously, they did this, so what else are they capable of? But I think we're in a moment right now where we're all carrying sort of a little bit of this burden. It's not just Rob anymore. It's like now everybody knows about this. So the company can't really focus on one person. There's just too many people to have to stifle and shut up.
We should want to nail DuPont. All of us should. American business is better than this, gentlemen.
Mark, you spent some time down under as well. Any trips to Australia planned? Any more picking up? You picked up some hitchhikers down under as well during your time there.
Yes, I did.
Are we expecting you to do that anytime soon?
I don't have anything planned unless Chris Hemsworth's going to invite me to his new palace.
Are you really? Do you really hang out? Like, we imagine this is just Hollywood.
No, we're friends. we all have been together for so long.
So you're just waiting for the invitation from
Thor. Yeah, Chris. Yeah. Chris. I know you got an extra bedroom.
He's got a lovely house too. By
there's somewhere for me in that place. You won't even have to see me.
Thanks very much for your time.
Thank you.
Our government is captive to DuPont. They're trying to force you to make me stop.
He was willing to risk his job, his family, for a stranger who needed his help.
The system is rigged. They want us to think it'll protect us. We protect us. We do.